Hello. My name is Khaled. I'm a frontier developer in LibreOffice, and I work mostly in text layout. This year we have Google Summer of Code for unifying low-level text layout in LibreOffice. Supposed to be a co-presentation with Akash, but he didn't make it to the presentation. Okay, so how does LibreOffice do text layout? So we have VCL module where all the work happens. There's a bot device class that provides the interface for other parts of LibreOffice, draw text array, get text layout, stuff like that. Output device in itself does not do text layout, uses another class called cell layout. I have no idea what cell is. Software abstraction something. And cell layout itself does not do text layout either. It uses subclasses for each platform, for each font technology, even for each writing system. So that is the current structure. We have like 10 sub-implementations of cell layout. I don't even know what many of them do. So we have graphite layout for graphite fonts. We have generic cell layout, not so generic actually, used only in Unix. And we have server font layout. And we don't do server fonts for like several decades or something. And we have PSB for PostScript printing. And we also have PSB server layout for PostScript printing. I don't know what is the difference between the two of them. And we have graphite layout, graphite server font layout. That is for graphite fonts on Unix as well. So like 5 classes on Unix just to do text layout. On Windows, we have simple one layout that is for so-called simple scripts, English, Greek, Cyrillic, stuff like that. And we have Uniscript, Inscribe, that is for complex scripts, Arabic, Nagari, Thai. And we also have graphite for Windows. On macOS, we have only one layout class that uses core text but does not do graphite fonts. So only on graphite is not supported on Mac, but only in Windows and Unix. And we have multi-cell layout. It took me actually like 5 years to understand multi-cell layout does font fallback. It's only purpose is doing font fallback, and it is used only on Unix, not used in Windows or in Cortex. Cortex does its own fallback. We don't control it. So I think it's obvious how much complexity do you have to just do the very low level text layout, taking some text, font file, and returning glyph indices and positions. That is nothing fancy at all. We have all these classes to just do this. So we have complexity of supporting all of this. 3 classes on Windows, 4 classes in Unix, to just to do PostScript printing, which we do not actually use by default. We use BDF printing by default. And one class on Mac, but we don't do graphite fonts on Mac. So, I think the complexity is obvious. Yeah. If you just do something simple, like adding user controllable features, something very basic, should be 10 lines of code or something. But you would need to know, to modify all these 8 classes at least. But The biggest problem is the inconsistency. So we have, we use different engines on Windows, on Unix, on macOS. Different platforms has different levels of support. Windows XP supports some scripts, some version of Unicode. Windows Vista supports newer one. Windows 8 supports even newer. Windows 10 supports much newer one. So a LibreOffice user in Windows XP will not get the same supported language and writing system as same user on Windows 10. And same between Windows and macOS. OpenType support in macOS have been historically very weak. Newer versions of macOS does better OpenType support, but older versions was much weaker. We also don't have graphite fonts on Mac, so if someone uses a minority language and needs graphite fonts, graphite is used mainly for minority or complex scripts that cannot be done with OpenType. No luck on Mac, you can't use it. And also, different platform APIs give us different levels of flexibility. So, for example, Cortex on macOS is very high level. Then we need, does bidirectional text layout, does font fallback, and all stuff we don't need. We need to coerce it into a low-level library to do what we need. And this is not very successful integration. We do not control font fallback on macOS, unlike other platforms. Windows Unscribe and DirectWrite provide low-level APIs that we can use. Unix is a fair game. So the solution, we just need one more class. So we had this year a Google Summer of Code project to unify the low-level text layout. We based our okay. So Akash Jain did the work and he did a very great job. I wish he would hear. It was my idea and it is also part of a Tinder project by TDF to support cross-platform reliable text layout testing, because we currently cannot do reliable layout testing across platforms. Because you might get different different line breaks, different page breaks, even between different platforms for the same text and same font. So it is one class that uses HarfBuzz for everything, even for graphite fonts, because HarfBuzz can do graphite fonts through LibGraphite. And even AAT. AAT is an Apple advanced text layout technology specific for Apple. There is no open source implementation for it. And HarfBuzz can call Cortex API for AAT fonts Max. We don't even need to care about it. We will just use HarfBuzz API for our layout. Font loading, like locating which mapping font names to font files and loading files in memory, is still done by platform APIs because it provides better compatibility with font installation and font loading across platforms. So HarfBuzz does only shaping. Shaping is taking a string of text and font file are returning which glyphs at which positions should be shown. HarfBuzz is a well-tested cross-platform library actively maintained, used by many big projects like Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Android, and even on some other small projects. Tracks latest versions of OpenType and Unicode, so if Unicode 10, Unicode, what's current version, Unicode 6 or 7, supported a new language, a new writing system, HarfBuzz will support it very quickly. We do not need to wait for Windows 11 or Windows 17 or whatever, because the version of Windows or macOS. OpenType introduced a new something called Universal Shaping Engine last year, and HarfBuzz supported it a few weeks after the specification was published. which is only supported in Windows by Windows 10. So with using HarfWaz, we get the latest and greatest versions of OpenType and Unicode support in whatever platform we use, whatever the native support by the platform is. So the current status, we have a new common cell layout class. We have generic cell layout and common cell. Naming things is hard. Code is integrated on Windows, Mac, and Unix platforms, and we can do layout and rendering all these platforms using single class. We have still some issues to be solved. There's some performance regressions, but I think we nailed most of it. Font fallback does not work currently on macOS because we never did font fallback on macOS. We relied on Cortex to do it. There's some small pieces missing to do font layout. Some complex graphite fonts are currently broken our implementation because we based our code on the Unix implementation, which was never used for graphite fonts. Graphite had its own layout engine, so we have some smaller bugs we need to fix and apply the XRH. Yes, slight performance regression in the new code, but I think we nailed the most of it. So just need to do some profiling and see if.
What area are
you using platform specific? No, the new class itself is slightly slower than the older implementation. All the old formats like Type 1 fonts or bitmap fonts are not currently supported. They can be supported, but I think LibreOffice should drop Type 1 font because Type 1 is very ancient format. Like it was killed 15 years ago or something, and we have lots of arcane code to support Type 1 fonts, so we are better off just killing it. But it can be supported, not would not be too much of change to support Type 1 fonts. We still do not use user controllable features that should be done at some point in the future. We had to use Direct Write API for loading fonts because JDI API is very branded. And so we currently do not support Windows XP, but it shouldn't be too hard for someone who understands this Windows GDI plus API to fix this, because it's just a very small function that needs direct write, not so much code depends on it. Code is currently in a feature branch, but we should land it in master soon. So soon on our master, we will have this a few remembers. Old one we had is this, and now we got a. We just made it even more complicated. We just added one more common cell output. But if things went right and no big regressions and no one complained very loudly, we will start killing old classes and just have common cell layout, which inherits from generic cell layout, which in turn inherits from cell layout. So we can just fold common cell layout into generic cell layout, or even more daydreaming, just have one cell layout class for them. So that is our hopefully the goal. So at this point we will be just have one single class, so we can start refactoring actual refactoring of the code. So the plan is to land the code in master and have it off by default. We can currently switch between the old implementation and new one at runtime using an environment variable. So after landing in master and making sure it builds on all platforms and there is no build problems, you can switch the new code on by default, allow for some testing, even at least for the next release, keep the two versions. And if no one complains very loudly, we can start killing the code for 5.4 release. So thank you.